to have such a beautiful, stunning piece must have just been jaw-dropping. It's jaw-dropping now, and I can only imagine then.
In Vienna, one of the leading cities for music and culture and art, the practitioners of the arts thought about collaboratives where the arts could be unified and be in artistic harmony. The Wittgenstein Vitrine, so named for its first owner, Carl Wittgenstein. This work is an incredible example of turn-of-the-century silver design. If you look at this object, indeed, it's a cabinet with glass, but it also has silver and gemstones and enamel work and two beautiful sculptural figures which flank either side of this cabinet. But it was a masterpiece of the Wiener Werkstätte, or Vienna Workshops. It was intended to bring together artists and designers and architects and others into this venture where they would work together to create luxurious, beautiful objects, very much in the progressive modern style, for the wealthy elite. The 1908 art show in Vienna, the Kunstschau, was an opportunity for the Wiener Werkstätte to exhibit their work and present them to the city as their great achievements in progressive design. And this particular vitrine was at the center of that. Standing over 5 feet tall, weighing nearly 200 pounds, constructed out of solid silver, encrusted with gemstones and enamel, it was intended as this great showpiece. Wittgenstein, certainly as a frequent client of the workshops, must have just fallen in love with this object. So he purchased it and installed it in the family home in Vienna, where it remained until Wittgenstein's death. The DMA has two excellent conservators, Mark Leonard, who's our chief conservator, and Fran Baas, who is our objects conservator and responsible for the work which was done on the Wittgenstein vitrine this last year. And they've done an absolutely superb job of bringing it back to what I think was very close to the original vision of the designers and craftspeople who made this vitrine possible.
It was in stable condition, but there were many, many years of it being lovingly polished to the point where there was polish residue stuck in every crevice in between the silver elements and the glass elements that needed to be removed. Also years of a disfiguring dark tarnish. The main priority and goal was to bring it back to its 1908 original brilliance as much as possible. In conservation, we use a delicate touch. We use minimum intervention, and we use materials that are known to be safe. The silver polishing that we do is standard in conservation, is a calcium carbonate slurry, and it gently removes the layer of tarnish. There's two side pieces of glass that are curved, and it's a complex curve. One of the pieces broke. It's a difficult piece to refabricate, but we still had a remaining one. So we were able to remove that, do a tracing of it, because it's also a large enough piece of glass that it can't be sand cast. It needed to have a steel mold made. Flickinger Glassworks in Brooklyn fabricated the steel mold. They sent us a sample to see a small sample of the curve. And it did fit, so we knew that for them to go ahead and make us the large piece. And they did it, and it looks wonderful. The original base was underneath several layers of re-veneering that were not original. So we had to take off those layers to get back to the original substrate and then re-veneer it. This project is so large, we touched a lot of other contractors and professions and conservators. It takes a village. Conservation doesn't happen really quickly because we think about what kind of things might happen. We're totally on when we are doing something. All of our senses are totally looking at the object, making sure that everything is going to be okay. And then it goes into a specially designed case by a company called Gopion, who happened to do also the case for the Mona Lisa. It's a stable environment that has an activated charcoal filter in the bottom. And what that does is it removes the sulfides in the air that causes the tarnish.
Acquiring the vitrine at the DMA provides us with another phenomenal masterpiece in our collection.
The DMA has very good taste. I think Kevin Tucker did an amazing job finding this piece. I think it is a great addition to the collection. And I feel that it shows how the museum collects wonderful works.